tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Who knew all the planes we flew, good things we've been through, that I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I see you again.
We've come a long way,
yeah, we came a long way
from where we began.
You know we started.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I'll tell you.
When I see you again.
You both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong. And what's small turn to a friendship turn to a bond. And that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first, then the line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn. And that line is what we reach, so remember me when I'm gone. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
So let the light guide your way, yeah. Hold every memory as you go. And every road you take will always lead you. It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you
wrapped around my finger, and it's so quiet in the world tonight. Your little eyelids flutter cause you're dreaming, so I tuck you in, turn on your favorite nightlight. To you, everything's funny. You got nothing to regret. I'd give all I have, honey, if you could stay like that. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up. Don't you ever can't do, and you can't wait to move out someday and call your own shots. But don't make her drop you off around the block. Remember that she's getting older too, and don't lose the way that you dance around in your PJs getting ready for school. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up, don't you ever grow up, just stay this little. Oh, darling, don't you ever grow up, don't you ever grow up, it could stay this simple. And no one's ever burned you, nothing's ever left you scarred. And even though you want to, just try to never grow up. Take pictures in your mind of your childhood room. Memorize what it sounded like when your dad gets home. Remember the footsteps, remember the words said, and all your little brother's favorite songs. I just realized everything I have is someday gonna be gone. So here I am in my new apartment in a big city. They just dropped me off. It's so much colder than I thought it would be, so I tuck myself in and turn my nightlight on. Wish I'd never grown up. I wish I'd never grown up.
From now, we'll all be gone. All our friends will move away, and they're going to better places. But our friends will be gone away. Nothing is as it has been. And I miss your face like hell. And I guess it's just as well. But I miss your face like hell. Oh, Oh,
TV, sunset done changed. Ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young.
if you're a little sissy. I don't know, but I was not. I was too scared.
Hey, Sergeant.
And what did I say? My spell worked.
We're playing the
water. Right. Good evening, senior class of 2023, parents and guardians, relatives and friends, teachers and administrators, superintendent and other central office personnel, and school board members. I am James Stratton, student council president. We welcome you to the 2023 commencement exercises of C.E. Byrd High School. Please stand for the posting of the colors by the C.E. Byrd High School Color Guard members and remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance, the National Anthem, and the Invocation. The Pledge of Allegiance will be led by Natasia Jacobs. Braden Tucker will sing the National Anthem. The Invocation will be given by Maxwell McDonald. Gentlemen, please remove your caps.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fights, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
please bow your heads as you join me in prayer. Dear God, thank you for allowing us to gather here today as we celebrate years of hard work, years that were filled with challenges and triumphs, losses and laughter, friendships and growth. Thank you for surrounding us with parents, teachers, and classmates who have pushed us to succeed and excel both in and out of the classroom. May each and every one of us feel gratitude as we reflect back on our experience at C.E. Byrd High School. Let us be filled with hope as we look toward the future, and as we go forth in the next chapter of our lives, please keep us safe and guide us as we strive to reach our fullest potential. Help us to keep you at the center of our lives and spread our faith in the situations we encounter. Continue to bless each of the graduates with love, mercy, opportunity, and wisdom. We ask all these things in your name. Amen.
I guess I get to say, please be seated. Good evening and welcome to the commencement program for the 98th graduating class of C.E. Byrd High School, the class of 2023. I would like to welcome our parents, guardians, relatives, friends, and graduates. Special welcome to Dr. T. Lamar Goree, our superintendent, who will deliver his remarks shortly, and also to Mr. Don Little, who is the school board representative from our district. We also have seated behind them Dr. Terrence Benson, who is our school board president, Ms. Jasmine Green, Ms. Barbara Smith Iverson, and Ms. Jessica Yates, and I'm hoping I didn't leave anybody out. Thank you. You know, toward the end of the school year, with all of the testing and things like that we do, we do not get the opportunity to recognize especially some of our seniors because they've been dismissed and things of that nature. So if you'll bear with me a minute, I want to just give some shout outs, so to speak. Byrd baseball, state quarterfinalist. Byrd track, state quarterfinalist with school records. Boys golf, state champions. And we had our first scholarship from our fishing team this year. And one of the best ones I heard the day after seniors left is Trinity Lions will be attending the United States Army West Point in the fall. So Trinity, congratulations to you. Before we deliver remarks, just some quick thank yous. Our counselors who do work hard all year long. They are not out here, but I am going to call their names. Freshman counselor who came in late this year, Megan Allen. Ms. Penny Eason, sophomore counselor. Tomiko Lacey, our junior counselor. And Amanda Byrd, our senior counselor, who's been literally running around for the last couple of weeks. Our senior class sponsor is Ms. April Carberry. And sitting right here in the front, it's going to be okay. We also have teachers who have children graduating tonight. We always recognize them. We have Coach Bruno and his daughter Mackenzie, Ms. Tabitha Trudnack and her daughter Abigail, and of course April Carberry and her daughter Caroline. And Dr. Goree, if you would deliver your remarks, we would appreciate it.
Thank you, Principal Badgley, and good evening. It is certainly my pleasure in my capacity as superintendent to welcome you to the graduation for the class of 2023 of C.E. Byrd High School. Let's give them a round of applause. I would be remiss if I didn't just pause to say thank you to all of the parents, loved ones, grandparents assembled here today. We truly do acknowledge the important contributions that you made to make this day possible. Graduates, today you will receive your high school diploma and all rights and privileges that go along with that. What I will tell you is that your presence here today is proof that you have met the academic requirements to receive this diploma. But what I'd like to talk to you today about is your backpack. You know, symbolically, every year, students would go out and you'd buy a backpack, and you'd use that backpack throughout the year to carry all of your supplies and your back and forth from school. What I tell you today is that over the last 13, you've accumulated in your backpack those things that you truly do need to be successful. I often tell people that the most important lessons that you need to know in life, you actually learned in kindergarten, and I'm a true believer of that. That's when you learn how to say thank you when something's given to you. That's when we reiterated the importance of sharing, and we learned to play well in a group. What I tell you is that those will be the tiebreaker skills that you will utilize as you progress through your next phases of life. I also want to remind you the importance of making good choices. Over the last 13 years, you've had many opportunities to develop critical thinking skills as well as problem-solving skills. As you go into life, you will meet obstacles. Every day won't be a great day. But what I encourage you to do is always remember those skills as you solve problems to make the best choices for yourself. I remind you, too, of the importance of setting goals. You sit here today because you had a goal to graduate from high school. As you go into your next phase of life, make sure you set those goals so that you can meet those desired outcomes as well. And one thing I think is so important about high school is that this is where most of us find our first genuine opportunity to provide community service to others. What I tell you, though, is your charge is to continue to find those places and opportunities to make this world a better place. You want to make sure you leave the world better than you found it. And last, as you look to the people sitting next to you, many of them have become your friends that you've talked to and communicated with every day. As you cross this stage, you probably won't see all of them every day, but I do encourage you to treasure the lifelong friendships that you have made while at CE Byrd. What I tell you is that these are the same people that will be there for you as you graduate from college, the same people that will be there for you as you get married and have children. These are your life friends, and make sure you cherish them as such. As I look out over the room, I'm so excited about the potential of everyone that sits here. I know for each of you, the very best is still yet to come. Congratulations, class of 2023. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Gorey. A very warm welcome this afternoon to graduates, family, and friends, and a special greeting to my daughter, Evelyn Little, whom I'm about to hand a diploma. We are so proud of you and all of your Byrd High School cohorts. They say that the most terrifying thing that a young soldier can hear is when the commanding officer screams in the din of battle, "Fix bayonets," because what happens next is absolute chaos. Graduates, I have two words for you this afternoon: fix bayonets. Because you, as you exit childhood, are about to go into intense battle. Because life is a fight. As Father Maximilian Kolbe, a saint and priest who voluntarily died in Auschwitz for a fellow prisoner, said, "The real conflict is an inner conflict. Beyond armies of occupation and the hectic homes of extermination camps, there are two irreconcilable enemies in the depth of every soul: good and evil, sin and love. And what use are the victories in the battlefield if we ourselves are defeated in our innermost personal selves?" Students, as you leave the comfort and protection of your childhood homes, depart the compassionate energy of your respective Caddo Parish classrooms, and in some cases venture out into new cities, states, and even countries, you will be stepping into battle. Your enemy will not give you the courtesy of an identifying uniform. The enemies that you will likely encounter are age old. And because of this, I welcome you to put on the full armor of God and know that as you step into a world that is simultaneously beautiful, good, and occasionally sinister, you are in many ways already surprisingly prepared for the struggles ahead in body, soul, and mind. Your bodies, through hours and days of athletics, are strengthened to endure treacherous journeys. Your souls have been kindled by the flames of love from your families, friends, and faith communities, a flame intense enough to burn through hatred. Your minds have been forged into spears of destiny by your caring teachers, weapons capable of piercing through ignorance. Never a doubt your ability to thrive, survive, and endure. I leave you with a quote from Coach Vince Lombardi, who says, "I firmly believe that any man's finest hour, the greatest fulfillment of all that he holds dear, is that moment when he has worked his heart out in a good cause and lies exhausted on the field of battle, victorious." Graduates, for those of you willing to fight, victory is yours. God bless you, congratulations, and please get home safely.
Now we will hear a reading from Jack Eli Ford, and Hannah Pierce will provide a challenge.
We are gathered here tonight to not only celebrate the culmination of 4 years of hard work, but also to celebrate the great possibilities that come with receiving a diploma. Unfortunately, with all of these great possibilities awaiting, one unsettling truth emerges. We are going to, at some point, all fail tremendously. And at these unavoidable times of seemingly unrelenting vulnerability, there are going to be people in this world that try to keep you down. However distressing this may sound, Teddy Roosevelt reminds us that in these lonely times of failure, to remember, it is not the critic who counts, not the person who points out how the strong man stumbles or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. Instead, the credit belongs to the person who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who at best, in the end, knows the triumph of high achievement, and who, at worst, if they fail, at least fails while daring greatly. So whatever arena you may enter after tonight, graduates, know that although you might be on your own, you too can face it. Thank you very much.
Good evening. Today is a day that many of us have looked forward to for quite some time. Whether you see today as just another day on the calendar or the most important day of your life thus far, it marks an important transition for all of us. Today, we begin a shift from high school into a new season of life. For some, this transition may be filled with great excitement, from eagerly awaiting what lies ahead. But for others, it may be filled with great fear and uncertainty. Whether you find yourself thrilled or terrified to enter a new stage of life, I challenge you to cherish it. Rather than wishing away the days and constantly longing for a time other than the present, I encourage you to look for the purpose in the season you're currently in. While it is often easier to cherish seasons of growth and celebration, I challenge you to remember that the same joy can be found in seasons of sorrow. Jackets, I wish you all the best of luck and pray the Lord blesses you in whatever your next season may be.
It is a long-standing tradition at C.E. Byrd High School that the commencement speaker is the parent of a graduating senior. To introduce our speaker for this special night is Brennan Belanger.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Brennan Belanger, and I have the privilege of introducing the commencement speaker, my mother, Kimberly Belanger. If you know my mother, you know she has a caring heart and a kind soul. She truly loves serving others and will always put herself last in order for others to succeed. These traits have shaped myself and my family in the most positive ways possible, and they will definitely stick with me for the rest of my life. Since I was young, she has always been my biggest supporter every step of the way. Whether it was getting me dressed when I was a young boy, late nights of calling out vocabulary and spelling words, advice on a substantial decision, or a hug after a tough loss playing the sports I love, she always did her best to encourage me and bring a smile back to my face. I'm happy to welcome my mother, Kimberly Belanger, to the stage.
Good evening. Give me a second. Thank you, Brennan, for the sweet introduction. And thank you to Mr. Badgley for inviting me to speak to our graduates. And thank you all for bearing with me if I cry or if I forget to breathe. It is a joy and an honor to be with you all here tonight as we celebrate the C.E. Byrd High School Class of 2023. We gather tonight to celebrate your academic achievements, as well as the many ways each of you have excelled beyond the classroom. Your Jacket family is proud of you and of the examples that you have set for our younger students, and we look forward to hearing about your successes in the future. Congratulations to each of you on a job well done. On behalf of everyone here who loves you and who has supported you, thank you to the Byrd faculty and administration for truly caring about the well-being and success of these students each and every day. Our family was first welcomed to the city of Byrd in the fall of 2016 when our oldest son, Brooks, chose to attend C.E. Byrd High School as a freshman. He then graduated with the class of 2020. As you know, our youngest son, Brennan, soon followed in his footsteps and is excited to be a member of the class of 2023. While I am not a Byrd graduate, the Byrd legacy runs deep in our family as both of my grandfathers, Brennan's great-grandfathers, are proud Byrd graduates. Our grandpa was a graduate of the class of 1939 and our papa, the class of 1945. While my grandpa has passed away, we are blessed to have my papa celebrating the class of 2023 with us tonight from home on the Facebook, as he calls it. Besides being proud Byrd graduates, my grandfathers have many things in common. They were Eagle Scouts, master woodworkers, they believed in the value of a strong work ethic, the necessity of keeping your word, and being responsible with your hard-earned resources. They were part of the greatest generation that served their country and their communities. They spent only what they made, and they were always willing to help someone in need, no matter the personal sacrifice. The legacies that my grandfathers left on their families made an indelible mark on Brooks, Brennan, and me. There is no doubt that the character, integrity, and work ethic with which they lived their adult lives was shaped by the lessons and values they learned as students at C.E. Byrd High School. So tonight, I would like to share five things that our family has learned from these two former Byrd graduates with you, the soon-to-be the most recent Byrd graduates, as you prepare to embark on the next chapter of your lives. First, be a dreamer. While you have achieved much during your years at Byrd, graduation is not the end of your journey. In fact, graduation signifies the beginning of the rest of your life. You were uniquely created with a purpose, and that purpose promises to lead you to a bright future. So set goals. Put in the hard work required to achieve those goals. Get up each day willing to make the sacrifices necessary to make your dreams a reality, and be willing to get back up when you fall down. The greater your effort, the greater your reward. Second, be strong and courageous. Some days will be like a walk in the park on a sunshiny day, where everything on your to-do list is checked off and life is going exactly according to plan. But at times, life will throw you a curveball, and you have to be ready to make adjustments in order to persevere. As my grandfathers and scouts everywhere would say, always be prepared. Don't become complacent. Be a lifelong learner. You never know when you are going to need a new skill or a plan of action to achieve your goals. But don't worry, you've already proven that you know how to persevere. Remember the COVID-19 pandemic that brought your high school experience to a screeching halt as mere freshmen? How could you forget? Optimism and opportunity were replaced by fear and uncertainty, but you did not get stuck in that fear. Instead, you persevered. You adapted to new ways of learning and living. You rose above the challenges and found a way to succeed. The proof is that you are here tonight, wearing a cap and gown, about to receive your diploma. Be proud of your achievements and be grateful for everyone at the City of Byrd who helped you to rise up when the world shut down. So don't be afraid of bumps in the road or dirt on your hands. Don't give up when the going gets tough. Instead, use unforeseen obstacles and mistakes that you make to hone your skills and solidify your determination to succeed. Third, be a difference maker. One of my favorite things about Byrd is that it challenges its students to leave their mark on Byrd, just as Byrd will leave its mark on each of them. Just inside the front entrance of the main building hangs a plaque dedicated by the National Honor Society in 1962 that reads, "You can never leave Byrd High School, for its training, its memories, and its reputation will go with you forever. Likewise, Byrd High School can never erase you. The mark you make on this institution will remain here for eternity. The same can be said for the next phase of your life. You are called to leave your mark on our world, to make our world a better place for future generations. While your vocational path might not yet be determined, you can make a difference in our world starting now. It has been said that your calling in life can be found where your passions intersect with your abilities. Each of you has God-given talents that are meant to be a gift to our world that only you can share. Your gift may be to work with your hands to build something new, to repair something that is broken, or create beautiful art. Your gift may be to use your brain to crunch numbers, analyze data, write persuasive briefs, or lyrical poetry. Your gift may be a physical strength that is meant to protect others, or an athletic ability to play professional sports or train the next generation of athletes. Perhaps your gift is one of compassion that calls you to encourage the hopeless, provide for the needy, or open your arms to the outcast. Whatever your gift, find something that you love to do and do it. Do it with your whole heart and to the best of your abilities. Like the 97 classes of Byrd graduates before you, make a contribution to your industry, to your community, to your families. Leave a mark on this world and make it a positive one. Each day, make it a goal to make a difference, big or small, to someone or something in our world. Fourth, be the light. There is too much darkness in the form of violence and sadness, discouragement and need in our world today. My grandfather struggled through the Great Depression and the horrors of the Second World War. Likewise, your youth has been marred by natural disasters, hate crimes, and a pandemic. While you cannot always control your circumstances, you can always control the way in which you react to those circumstances. Choose to be the one who shines grace and mercy, hope and kindness so bright that the darkness fades away. One of my favorite authors, Bob Goff, in his book Love Does, wrote, "It will be our love, not our opinions, that will be our greatest contribution to the world." Bob is right. Love is always the brightest light that you can shine. Choose to light our world with love and watch the darkness disappear. And finally, be you. You are fearfully and wonderfully made, and you are loved just the way you are. Your uniqueness is what makes you special. Be true to yourself, and you will most certainly find your place in this world. This past weekend, our family celebrated my papaw's 95th birthday. His is a life well lived, and thankfully, he is not done yet. Over the years, he has taught us many things, but one thing he tells me and my boys over and over again is that you are the captain of your own ship, meaning you are in control of your own destiny. I share this tidbit of grandfatherly advice with you tonight so that you will believe that you can do anything you want to do or be anything you want to be. I hope that you will follow the examples of my grandfathers and thousands of other Byrd graduates and choose to dream big. Choose to be strong and courageous. Choose to be different makers. Choose to be the light and choose to be yourselves as you live the legacy that is the CE Byrd High School class of 2023. Our family has been blessed to be a part of the city of Byrd, and the purple and gold of CE Byrd High School will always beat deep within our hearts. Congratulations, Jackets.
We'll say thank you, Ms. Belanger, and we have a little token of our appreciation from the class of 2023. Thank you.
At this time, we will make a special tribute to parents, teachers, and administrators. Tonight, a presentation to parents will be made by Christian Jones, Mary Juno, Anna Marie Kemper, and Cash Sumlin. A presentation to teachers will be made by Seth Guerra, Caroline Hannigan, Shelby Sanders, and Kaylin Weaver. Marina Klein, Ellie Lawrence, Evelyn Little, and Kyla Washington will present a tribute to administrators.
To our parents, grandparents, and loved ones, we would like to thank you on the behalf of the class of 2023. We wouldn't be where we are today without your constant support and guidance that has shaped our path for the future.
From the day we were born to today, as we walk across the stage as graduates, you have unconditionally loved us and been our source of encouragement.
Your commitments to our future has allowed us to flourish into the people in front of you. Today is a demonstration of the values that we have been gifted from you due to your unwavering dedication, selflessness, and kindness.
So we thank you for molding us into a class who is able to take on the uncertainty of the future with our heads held high. We are forever grateful for you. We love you.
The definition of a teacher is as follows. High school teachers teach academic lessons and various skills that students will need to attend college and enter the job market. While this definition may be true for the average teacher at other schools, at Byrd, all teachers go beyond just that.
Our teachers encourage us to explore our interests, help dive into the content headfirst, give us the opportunity to excavate the deepest channels of knowledge within ourselves, and prepare us for our futures beyond what's immediate.
At Byrd, our teachers put in the extra work and give unwavering support to their students that led us to this moment today.
It may not be much compared to what they have done for us, but we feel that the least we can do is give all of our teachers a round of applause to show them how much we appreciate them. Thank you.
On behalf of the entire senior class, we would like to say a very well-deserved thank you to our administration. The administration are the ones who help facilitate our high school experience.
We appreciate all of your hard work that was put into knowing what is the best for us. You all have worked effortlessly in supporting us so we could reach our full potential.
From our first day, you all have done everything in your power to make this school year go by smoothly. Your dedication to us has not gone unnoticed, and we are grateful for your commitment.
High school would truly not be possible without all of y'all working seamlessly behind the scenes to make our 4 years at Byrd so memorable.
We are at that point where we're about to hand out diplomas. Before Ms. Prothrow and Ms. Johnson come up and start calling names, let me really plead with you for a moment. Graduates and our audience, we want every single student that is graduating tonight and their family, and their family to be able to hear their name called. As we read the names, we do not pause for any, you know, rounds of applause or anything like that. We really would like you to hold your applause. Let us call all the names, and then I promise you, we'll give you an opportunity to bring the house down. Thank you.
Thank you.
Chloe Jane Miller.
What order are they?
Hannah Renee Pierce. Jackson Eli Lowry Ford. Here, let me do this one. Kaylin Michelle Weaver. Shelby Ann Sanders. Caroline Elizabeth Hannigan. Natasia Rochelle Jacobs. Maxwell Christopher McDonald. Brennan Michael Belanger. Christian Michael Jones. Mary Margaret Juno. Anna Marie Kemper. Christopher Cash Sumlin. Braden Emil Tucker. James Frank Stratton. Seth Austin Guerrera. Nolan Isaac Bruce. Justice Davion Brokenberry. Elizabeth Ann Klotzbach. Elizabeth Nicole Witten. Gracie Ann Chisholm. Chloe Jane Miller. Ella Elise Price. Kenjamion Ontario Scott. Catherine Whitaker Briary. Kyla Catherine Washington. Evelyn Margaret Little. Eleanor Kate Lawrence. Marina Lily Klein. So that's where I start. Okay. Caden Cole Adcock. Jakayla Gail Adger. Daniel Alexander Ia. Destiny Deshay Allen. Joshua Glenn Allen. Ann Estelle Anderson. Xavier Deshaun Anderson. Sarah Christian Andrews. Kaylee Elise Armstrong. Andrea Leanne Baker. Taylor Gage Bamberg. Sierra Elise Barnes. Caitlin Miranda Barnett. Courtney Nicole Barr. Nisiah Deshelle Barrett. Kentrell Jamar Beasley. Markeo Lamar Beasley. Shepherd Brooks Benson. Kalena Grace Beniak. Haley Virginia Bishop. Hannah K. Bland. Brock Ryan Boddy. Allison Hope Bond. Quatreshawn Dwayne Bolden. Brian Tremaine Bonner. Shalala Arion Boone. John Lee Bowen Jr. Landon Neal Boykin. Nathaniel Tucker Bracey. Kaylin Peyton Bradford. Jade Delyn Bradford, Tyler Catherine Brandt, McKinley Faith Brannon, Jakayla Lachey Bridgewater, Bryce William Britnell. Okay. Christian Michael Brooks, John Brooks Brochet, Jalexis Alicia Michelle Brothers, Jet Joshua Broussard, Asia Nicole Brown, Chantel Andrea Brown Wesley, Mackenzie Ann Bruno, Azriel Lynn Burris, Catherine Elizabeth Burchett, Allison Marie Burnett, Emma Caroline Carberry, Lola Beth Carroll, Taya Natasha Carroll, Graham Stephen Carter, Olivia Michelle Clark, Robin May Clark, Peyton Elizabeth Collier, Asia Danielle Cook, Ethan Edward Kuhn, Grace Lee Copa, Joseph Asher Costanza, Lindsay Renee Krager, Devlin McKenzie Crane, Kyle Grant Cross, Rebecca Ann Cup, Danasia Ion Dale, Braylon Neal Daniels, Kia Sky Daniels, Caden Michael Davidson, Cicely Emaya Lynette Dawson, Trace Dodson Deal, Ethan Wayne Dial, Jackson Charles Dufresne, Kendall Faith Duggan, Riley Addison Eastland, Kyla Trine Edwards, Lachadrine Siobhan Edwards, Marissa Laney Evans, Chandler Blaine Ezernak, Adeline Gray Factor, Jacob Benjamin Fields, Isaiah Deshun Ford, Walker Reed Fox.
Slow down for Frederick.
Okay. Michael Corey Frazier, Tristan Joseph Anthony Frederick, Carson David French, Ava Marie Milhouse Fromm, Courtney Nicole Fuller, Dakota Lane Futch, Reese Simone Godet, Lonterion Deshaun Germany, Nathan Branyan Gibson, Marquesha Rashunda Gail Gray, Hannah Grace Green, Jason Lamar Green, Joshua Emmett Green, Casey Nicole Green, Omarion DeAndre Green, Maggie Elizabeth Griffin, Jordan Kendall Guillory, Aaron Starshay Hansen, Trenton Edward Harbor, Donald Cruz Harden, Samaya Jaquana Harper, Chriselle Malisi Harris, Kadarian Rashun Harris, Sakari Shervern Haywood, Dixie Grace Hendricks, Joy Amanda Hernandez, Braden Latrace Hill Burns, Hayden Ramsey Hoffpower, Adrian Dominic Hollinger, Riley Nicole Hudson, Richard Caden Hutchinson, Demarion Deshaun Jackson, Tyquin Lamar Jackson, Leah Trinity Jenkins, Quayshawn Lamar Jones, Madeline Grace Joyner, Nasavia Monet Joyner, Sarah Ryanan Cam, Ryan Alexis Kennedy, Elijah Blaine Kent, Lisa Catherine Kent, Christopher Aiden Cannell, Addison Elise Cole, Briley Lynn Coos, Haley Kiana Jaden LaCour, Jonquez Kanye Royland LaCour, Brian Decavian Lacey Jr., Lake Charles Lambert, Kennedy Jaslyn Lampkin, James Cameron Latier, Cassidy Paige Lee, Landry Kate Linto, Archionde Zachariah Tamervion Lewis, Clemente Dion Logan, Ethan Earl Long, Emma Catherine Lloyd, Trinity Tyler Lyons, Maribella Mia Maldonado, Yermiah LaAngel Marcray, Riley Claire Marshall, Amelia Paige Martin, Jaden Alexandria Martin, Benjamin Allen Martinson, Angelique Kiera Mason,
Mason Ivy McCarty, Hayes McClinton IV, Connor Wesley McClure, Jaylee Ann Marie McCullough, Marshall Drew McCullum, Mason Cade McCormick, Chad Wade McCray, Molly Elizabeth McMillan, Brandon Larry McWilliams, Dawson Thomas Meeks, Azaria Sierra Mickle, Colton Dale Miller, Connor Riley Miller. Gunner James Miller. Rylan L. Miller. Elena Marie McMillan. Milliken. Clavonda Annette Lachey Mitchell. Haley Nicole Mitchell. Bailey Nicole Moore. Jean-Corey Emmanuel Moore. Kaylin Henry Moore. Lila Deshae Moore. Ayana Nicole Morris. Lauren Elizabeth Mouchon. Landry Kate Nation. Arlie Michelle Neely. Marion K. Nelson. Zachary Taylor Newton. Tyler Payne Nichols. Melanie Margaret Nolan. Balia Shakendra O'Neill. Kelis Chriselle O'Neill. Fiona B. Odell. Peyton Ann Odom. Tatiana Kaylin Oliver. Evan Carter Pace. Louise Eric Padilla. Ariana Janaya Parker. Jack Stephen Parsons. William Jude Partington. Victoria Ann Patton. William Kelly Payne. Logan Elliott Pelliquin. Emmanuel David Pena. Cadence Lonine Pennington. Thomas Allen Perryman. Kadaris Tyrell Pursley. Youssef Yanni Petticus. Malia Lacine Pipkins. Dahlia Kalina Player. Michael David Ponsego. Christopher Dwayne Pringle. Sevion Amir Raxter. Abigail Jane Ramsey. Caroline Marie Ramsey. Robert Joseph Ramsey. Kavondre Jamal Randall. Madison Taylor Reed. Tyler Lane Richardson. Connor Gene Reitenauer. Cole Knox Rimmer. John Matthew Talento Rena. Kevin Daniel Robinson. Tyler Nathaniel Luke Robinson. Madison Ann Rook. Robert Vincent Rose. Wesley Damon Roussel. Zoe Reagan Rowe. Rylan Jack Russell. Jackson Walker Rust. Dayton James Ryder. Leslie Salinas. Sage Blaze Sanders. Taurus Lynn Sanders. Elena Morgan Scott. Darius Joseph Scott. Kelby Marlon Scott. Marlena Marie Scott. Miles Joseph Scott. Jeffrey Aiden Sexton. Landon Shane Shepherd. Anaya Sierra Smith. Jamari Ayana Rochelle Smith. Kaylee Michelle Smith. Caleb Henry Smith. Malachi Deshaun Smith. Megan Elizabeth Smith. Parker Kevin Smith. Zachary Thomas Smith. Philip Brown Snyder. Anna Catalina Solis. Andrew Ford Spivey. Aston Kyle Sprague. Caitlin Rose Stage. Grayson Gianna Steer. Kathleen Rose Stevens. Devon Ramsey Strickland. Caitlin Ann Marie Sutton. Gabriel Brandon Taylor. Tabor. Ariel Michelle Taylor. Deja Calise Taylor. Javen Armand Taylor. LaMichael Lamore Taylor. Jackson Thomas Thickpen. Chastity Elise Thomas. Jalen Travon Thomas. Keyshawn Raymond Thomas. Laquelle Fianta Thomas. Michael Wayne Thornton Jr. Jacob Hunter Thrasher. Tanaya Ronshina Tillman. Anna Camille Toms. Catherine Nicole Toops. Kendall Olivia Townsend. Lucas Paul Trosclair II. Abigail Christine Trudnack. Clara Elizabeth Turner. Michaela Danae Turner. Cameron O'Shea Tyner. Janiyah Nicole Vanderpool. Kaylee Clarissa Van Zandt. Christian Tyrese Washington. Percy Leroy Washington III. Zanaya Gabriel Gale Waters. William Wyatt Watkins. Jaquaria Marie Watson. Shania Rashawn Lachelle Watson. Blaine Ryan Webb. Mary Paris Wellington. Trinaya Nicole White. William Fields Whitman. Bennett Cheney Wicker. Xavier Rashawn Wiggins. Elijah Xavier Jashawn Williams. Jaderia Joseria Williams. Shania Zanita Williams. Luke Neil Wilson. Lakeisha Danielle Wobbington. Kaylee Marie Wolf. Nicholas Halam Wright. Isabella Santana Young. Morgan Santana Young. Sydney Santana Young.
Okay. The last picture's been made, and before I do my official duties, I always like to give a little information without naming any specific names, but collectively about the class of 2023. A lot of accomplishments, there always are. This class has just a little over 300 students, 300 graduates. 283 of these graduates, if they choose to stay in Louisiana, will earn some form of TOPS. 164 of these graduates have earned college credit. 24 could enter college as sophomores. There's some benefit to that besides early graduation. We have one that has enough hours to enter college as a junior. Their total college credit hours are 2,550. 33 have straight A's through high school. There are 35 AP scholars, 16 AP capstone diploma students. This year we have 15 students that have earned advanced statewide credentials. These are students that go to the Career Center, work very hard, and have gotten themselves an up, so to speak, on the job market, and they're still in a position to go to college if that's what they choose. Before we get away from that, I also want to say we've got a number of students that will be going into the military, both active duty and the National Guard, and I certainly salute each and every one of you. We have four that are winners of the Colonial Dames Essay Award, a winner of the United States Senate Youth Program, a National Merit Commended Student, a National Merit African American Recognition Award, two National Merit Finalists. All of these awards, their scholarship offers, the value of their college credit that they've earned is over $15 million. So class of 2023, I tip my hat to you. Now I'm going to ask Nolan Bruce, Justice Brokenberry, Elizabeth Klotzbach, and Elizabeth Witten to go to whichever microphone you're supposed to go to. Y'all are all going to be over here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Class of 2023, would you please stand? By the power vested in me, by the Louisiana State Board of Elementary and Secondary Education, I declare that you have met the requirements for graduation, 24 or more Carnegie units, passed all required LEAP exams, and are now graduates of C.E. Byrd High School. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the 98th graduating class of Byrd High School. Congratulations.
Throughout high school, we have been challenged to overcome many obstacles and adversities. We will use these lessons learned to continue to grow into successful individuals that will better the world around us.
High school has always been about more than just grades, and we have learned to balance it all in the last 4 years. From sports to clubs to friendships to grades, we have left a legacy we are proud of.
As we continue this walk of life, let's remember to remain persistent, passionate, and most of all, determined to succeed in whatever we put our minds to.
Today marks the end of one journey and the beginning of another. Now we graduate by moving our tassels from right to left. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Seniors, please remain standing for an introduction to the alma mater by Gracie Chisholm, Chloe Miller, Ella Price, and Kenjamian Scott.
Graduates, as you know, music has a way of transporting you back to a particular place and time and often conjures up unforgettable memories.
During our years here at Byrd, I'm sure we can all remember a time where we sang the alma mater and felt a unique connection with our classmates.
For about a minute, we all come together and sing the same words to the same tune, swelling with a sense of pride in our school.
Singing this song is a way for us to remember the times that we cherished at the great city of Byrd. We invite you to stand up, lock arms just one more time, singing as loud and as proud as you can from deep within your heart.
Graduates of 2023 and guests, please stand for the benediction given by Catherine Briery.
Please bow your heads for a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for allowing us the opportunity to be a part of the city of Byrd these past 4 years. Thank you for the memories and friends we have made and for the teachers and administration who have invested in us every day. Thank you for allowing us to celebrate the graduation of this senior class. Please guide us in our footsteps and help us to make wise decisions. Lord, please go before us as we enter into this next chapter of life and let all we do be for your glory. In God's name we pray, amen.
Audience, please be seated for the recessional. Congratulations, CE Byrd, class of 2023.